யா ஹலோ எவ்ரிவன், வெல்கம் டு நரேஷ் ஷெட்டி, திஸ் இஸ் நவீன். யா ஸோ இந்த லாஸ்ட் வீடியோ வி ஹாவ் டிஸ்கஸ் அபவுட் த வெரி ஃபர்ஸ்ட் மினி ப்ராஜெக்ட் ஆஃப் HTML, ரைட்? யா ஸோ நவ் வில் டிஸ்கஸ் த கான்செப்ட் கால் HTML ஃபார்ம்ஸ். ஸோ வாட் இஸ் HTML ஃபார்ம்ஸ், வாட் ஆர் த டேக்ஸ் தேர் இன் த HTML ஃபார்ம்ஸ், அண்ட் வாட் ஆர் ஆல் டேக்ஸ், ஐட்ரிபியூட்ஸ், இன்புட் ஆட்ரிபியூட்ஸ் அண்ட் எவ்ரி திங் வில் லேர்ன். அண்ட் தென் வில் டூ ஒன் சிம்பிள் மினி ப்ராஜெக்ட் தட் இஸ் கால்ட் ஆன்லைன் ஜாப் அப்ளிகேஷன் ஃபார்ம். ஓகே, யா. ஸோ வாட் இஸ் ஃபார்ம்? ஸோ ஃபார்ம் மீன்ஸ், யூ நோ, ஆஸ் ஆஃப் நோ வி ஜஸ்ட் த சிஸ்டம் இஸ் கன்வேயிங் சம் இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் ஃபார் அஸ், ஸோ ஜஸ்ட் மெசேஜஸ் அண்ட் ஆல் இமேஜஸ் அண்ட் ஆல், ரைட்? ஸோ நவ் ஃப்ரம் த ஃபார்ம் ஆன்வர்ட்ஸ், ஸோ வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு கன்வே, ஐ மீன் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு கிவ் சம் இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் டு த சிஸ்டம். ஸோ யூ நோ ஃபார்ம் மீன்ஸ் இட் இஸ் ஜஸ்ட் லைக் யூசர் நேம் அண்ட் இன்புட் ஃபீல்ஸ் வில் பி தேர், ஸோ வேர் யூ ஹாவ் டு என்டர் யுவர் ஓன் இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் டு த சிஸ்டம். ஸோ ஒன்ஸ் யூ கிளிக் ஆன் த சப்மிட் பட்டன், ஒன்ஸ் யூ கிளிக் ஆன் த சப்மிட் பட்டன் ஆஃப் த ஃபார்ம், ஸோ த என்டையர் ஃபார்ம் டேட்டா விச் இஸ் கலெக்டட் பை த ப்ரௌசர் அண்ட் தென் இட் சென்ட்ஸ் டு த சர்வர் ஃபார் த ப்ராசஸ். ஸோ நவ் லெட் சி, ஸோ வாட் ஆர் த ஃபார்ம் டேக்ஸ் அவைலபிள் அண்ட் வாட் ஆர் த டேக்ஸ் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு லேர்ன் இன் திஸ் கிளாஸ். ஓகே, யா. ஸோ ஹியர், ஸோ வேரியஸ் டைப்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஃபார்ம் அட்ரிபியூட்ஸ், ஃபார்ம் எலிமெண்ட்ஸ் வில் பி தேர், லைக் டெக்ஸ்ட் பாக்ஸ், பாஸ்வேர்ட்ஸ், ரேடியோ பட்டன், செக் பாக்ஸஸ் அண்ட் ஆல் திஸ். ஸோ லெட்ஸ் ஹாவ் எ லுக். ஓகே, யா. ஸோ ஹியர் இன் திஸ் ஃபார்ம் வி ஹாவ் டிவைடட் இன்டூ த்ரீ செக்ஷன்ஸ். ஸோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் வி லேர்ன் அபவுட் HTML5 ஃபார்ம் எலிமெண்ட்ஸ். ஸோ ஃபார்ம் எலிமெண்ட்ஸ், ஸோ லைக் இன்புட், செக் பாக்ஸ், ரேடியோ பட்டன், செலக்ட் பாக்ஸ் அண்ட் ஆல் திஸ் வி லேர்ன் ஃபர்ஸ்ட். அண்ட் தென் there are some input form input types. Okay, so that we learn next, and then form input attributes. So once we learn all this, so we're clubbing all together, we'll be developing online job application form websites. Okay, so let's get started. Yeah, so today we are going to learn this form elements. Today we are going to learn the form elements. Okay, yeah, so let me open the editor. Yeah, this is my webstorm ID. So here HTML forms, let me go to, so file number 14. Yeah, let me open this file number 14. So I have started my live server. Yes, I have started my live server. So this is my live server. Okay, yeah, so here let me open the file number 14, form elements. Yes, so let me open this. Yeah, so here now we'll start coding here. So let me change the title first. So HTML form elements. Okay, yeah, so here in this section we are going to learn this HTML form elements. Yeah, these are the various form elements we are going to learn today. Okay, so input and label. So label means for any form elements, if you want to write like username and one text box, so what the username word is, label. So like enter your comments and one text box, or radio button, I mean comments box, right? So this is label. So label for any input text box, and then select box. So how we can do the drop down, that is by using select and option tag, and then text area if you want to write some comment box, that is text area, and then button means simple button, and then data list. So we'll see all this. Yeah, so here input. Yeah, let me add a simple input. So what I'm going to add is, so just username and one text field, password, one password box, and then simple submit button. Okay, so very first login form. Okay, yeah, so here whatever the things you want to enter, that should be inside a form. It should be inside a form tag. So form is a root element for all the form elements. So whatever the form tag you want to write, it should be inside a form element. Okay, yeah, so just add a division. So I have added division just for styles purpose. Yeah, add a form, sorry. So add a form tag. So in the form tag, so let me add two things. One is username, one is password. So let me add a label, that is username. Okay, let me check the output. Yeah, username. Okay, so after this label, so next side to the label, let me add one input, type equal to text. So if you want to enter any text box, if you want to get a text box on the web page, you must have to use this one, input type equal text. If you say input type equal text, so text box will be display. Okay, yeah, so next, yeah, so there is one prerequisite here, I mean there is one simple condition here. If you write a label, see this is a label, this is a form element. So for this label, this is the only form element. So how can you combine these two? How can you link these two? Okay, so let's see how can you combine this. See, this username is the label and this is the text box. So how can you combine these two? Okay, so the logic here is, you have to give one for attribute for label, okay, so some username, see it is in red color, so that for whatever the thing you want to add, so that will be the ID of the inputs. See, now proper, yes, no error. See, so how can you link this label with the text boxes? So for the label there is one attribute called for, and with text box there is one attribute, any input field there is one attribute called ID. So this ID and for should be same, then only. So yes, this label is for this particular text box, okay, so that link is there. So now, so after this in the next line, so let me add a br tag, br not caps, br tag, yeah. The next line, let me add one more label, that is password. So label password, okay, so let me check, yes, password. So for this password, let me give something called for password, password, okay. So and then let me add one input, yeah. So if you want to get a password box, that is simple, input type equal to password. If you say input type equal to password, you'll get the password box. So ID password, okay, yeah. And then the last, let me add one submit button. So let me add a br tag. So here input type equal to submit, and value equal to submit, okay, yeah. This is one simple form, okay. So see here, what is the difference between text box and password box? So for text box, so whatever the text you enter, it will be visible, but for password, whatever the text you enter, it will be dots, okay. That is the difference between text box and password box, and this is a submit button. So here, so how does this effect has come, how the effect has come, so how these dots are coming, that is simple. Here input type equal to password. If you say input type equal to password, you will get this kind of password box. If you say input type equal to text, so the text is visible. Okay, let me do something like the password, instead of password, I'll say text only. So what happens, both are text box only, even though it is a password field, yes, both are text. So how the dots are coming is input type equal to password. If you just say input type equal to password, it converts like a password box. Okay, so browser will take care, depend on the type of value what you provided. So based on that, if you say input type equal to text, text box will be display. If you say input type equal to password, one password box will be display. If you type input type equal to radio button, input type equal checkbox. So input type equal data, date selector, date time, and date time selector, and all this, okay. So browser will take care about all this, yeah. So now, yeah, so let me add, it's not seems like a form only, 100%, yeah. So let me add some simple styles for this, okay. So now, yeah, so go to top, yeah, here below title, add a simple style tag, so div open close. So let me add some styles for this, okay. So what styles is, let me add some nice background color, orange color, okay. Let me add little font to family, some font, okay. So sans serif, some font, yes, yeah. And also let me give little padding 10 pixels, okay, yes, 10 pixels padding. And then let me add a little margin, that is 5 pixels, so 5 pixels margin, yes, yeah. See, now this is and also you can give some width, some 400 pixels, okay. So let me, I have zoom it actually, so for you it looks like this, yeah, 100%, yeah, it looks like this, okay, yeah, simple form. But you know, you observe carefully, it's not like a properly aligned, right? So this is not properly aligned. So sir, how can you make this properly aligned? So username, it is went somewhere, and password went somewhere, and submit is here. So how can you make this properly aligned? So here, actually we can do this by using a lot of CSS is required, but at this point of time, we have not started CSS, right? So there's one trick, by using table tag, we can convert like a properly aligned, okay, properly aligned form, okay. So here, just observe this one. See, username, okay, so username is one row, okay, so just observe, like this is the complete table by using table tag. So observe, this is like a table. So first row, in the first row, username is first table data, and the text box is one more table data in the same row. Okay, in the next row, password one table data, password field is one table data, and in the next row, submit is one table data. So if you assume this, so it looks like it comes like properly aligned. Okay, yeah. And also one more thing, there is no borders will be displayed by default, so it is useful for us, right? Yeah. So let me convert this entire form as a table form, table related form. Okay, so how can you add tables and how can you manage the styles? Okay, so here, yeah, come down. So after this, just add a h2. This is a table form. See, yeah, I have added table form. Yeah, table. How, if you add a table, how it will be? Okay, so for that reason, I have added table form. Okay, yeah. So here, yeah, below this, add a division, so that the styles will be applied same styles. Yeah. So in the division, let me add a form. Yeah. So inside the form, see, inside the form, username, password, right? So these two comes under table. So that first table should be there, right? Yeah. So what I'm doing is add a table tag, table open close. Yeah. So in the table, the very first one, so no table header, no table body. So that is optional. So direct table row, table data. So let me add a table row. So in the table row, the username is first table data. So table data. Okay, so in the table data, let me add direct username, or let me add a label. Yeah, table data. So label. Okay, user name. Okay, yeah, so username. Okay, yeah, next is what? Text field. So text field in the same row as a table data. So what I'm doing, so this is the same row. So in the same row, one more table data, that is what? Inputs. Input type equal to text. See? Yeah, now properly it has come, username and this one. Yeah. Next row. So next row, table data, each table data, right? Yeah. So here table row. Yeah, first row is over, next row. So after close of table row, add one more table row. Yeah, so here table data, the very first table data, so that is again what? Label. Okay, label. So label, what is a label? Password. So password. Okay, yes, password has come. Yeah, and then next, in the same row, table data as a password box. So here same row, table data. So here inputs type equal to password. Okay, that's it. Yeah, see, now it seems like a properly aligned, right? So when compared to this one and this one, it's properly aligned, right? So simple, this is seems like a table. So this is one table row and this is one table row. Okay, so yeah, next one more table row for submit button. Okay, so same thing, after close of table row, add one more table row. Okay, so add a table data. So the very first table data is input type equal to submit. See, now it seems like a proper form, right? So when compared to the first one and second one, so the second one, it seems like a properly aligned, right? Yeah. So by using table, you can just adjust this. Okay, so simple. We just mix the table along with the form element. So in the table data, instead of adding this normal content, we just added this form tags. Okay, yeah. So that is this one, username and password box and submit button. Okay. Your next, we'll see the select box. So how can you do the select box? So how the drop down will come? Okay, yeah, for drop down, yeah, let me add something for division. So add a form. Yeah, if you want to get a drop down, there's a tag called select. Okay, so select is a main tag. Inside each option is option tag. Okay, so let me add a select. Yeah, before this, let me add a simple label. Okay, label. So what label? Select a language. Select a language. Okay, so yes, select a language. Yeah, here I want to add a drop down. Okay, so here inside of this, yeah, add a select. See, select, open close. So select is a main element for actual drop down. So each item inside the drop down is option. Okay, so option. So what I'm going to add is HTML. See, HTML. Okay, so same like this, let me add some more options. So all the UI technologies, let me add. Okay, so this is CSS, and this is JavaScript, and this is jQuery, and this is Ajax, and then this is Bootstrap, and then last one is AngularJS. Oh, AngularJS. Yeah, see, select a language. So here you have a drop down. So it is like coming like a drop up. So it is going upside, right? So because we don't have any space, enough space in the bottom. So yeah, let me reduce. Yeah, see, this is a drop down. Okay, so if you don't have enough space in the bottom, so it comes like a drop up. So but it's a drop down only. Yeah, so yes, yeah, after drop down. So this is a simple drop down. So select inside each option is one option. Okay, yeah, that is one simple this one. Yeah, next to text area. So you know, for any forms there is something called comment box, messages box. Okay, so for that one, while filling any form, one submit your query. So if you want to add a lot of text, so for that there is something called text area. Okay, so let me add a text area now. So division, add a form. So form, what text area? Let me add a label. So what I want to add is some enter your message. Yes, enter your message. Yeah, now here I want to add a text area. So simple, text area means there is a tag called text area. See, text area. So for text area, so nothing should be there inside, but only two mandatory attributes, that's called rows and columns. So how many number of rows you want, how many number of columns you want. So rows equal to 5, so I want some 5 rows, and columns I want some 20. See, this is one text area. So you can even increase this some 30 or something. Yeah, see, this is like bigger text area. So you can add your comments and everything, whatever you want to add, you can just add it. Okay, so this is a comment box. We call it as, in the HTML language, we call it as text area by using the tag called text area. Okay, yeah. So for button, button means one simple button. If you just say button value equal to button, so simple button, but we never use this button. We use this button for JavaScript. If you click on this, so something should happen, on click event, something and all. Okay, but this button is not useful for forms, just for a simple button. Okay, yeah, data list. Yeah, now let's see the data list. So when you add a data list, so data list is same like a drop down, but it's more than drop down. Okay, yeah, so here first let me add some br. okay, br. Okay, yeah, so for data list, so here, so add a division. Okay, so you have added a division. Yes, okay, so in the division let me add a form. Okay, so in the form, so let me add a label. Here again, select a language. Okay, yeah, so this data list has come from HTML5 version. Okay, so whatever the things we have learned, those are all HTML previous versions up to HTML4, and this is the only thing, the tag which is coming from HTML5 elements. Okay, so we'll see the input types and all HTML5 separately. Okay, yeah, so this is for HTML5 tag. Okay, yeah, so for this input, list equal to some technologies. Yeah, here the syntax and everything is different. List equal to technologies, and some name, just give some name called tech. Yeah, so here there's something called data list, open close. Yeah, so for data list, I think there will be one id technologies and values. Okay, so id, so technologies. Okay, yeah, so it has to match. So this list and this data list has to match. Okay, so here let me add one option. Okay, so for this close also not required. Yeah, this is the syntax for this. Yeah, option value equal to HTML. Okay, yeah, let me add proper all the options now, and then I'll just dictate the demo. I'll show you the demo. Yeah, here HTML, and this is CSS, and this is JavaScript. Okay, yeah, here it is jQuery, and here it is Bootstrap. Okay, and here it is AngularJS. Okay, yeah. So in the last, let me have a simple submit button. Okay, so after data list, so input type equal to submit, and here value equal to submit. Okay, yeah, see. So let me open this. Yeah, see here, what's the difference between it is a refined version of drop down. Okay, so here in the drop down you have to select each and every value. So here for data list, so as soon as you say some J, see all the options are coming, JavaScript, jQuery and all this. So here no need to select the entire list. So the so one particular situation I'll tell you. So for this drop down, so you know some 100 values are there. So each and every value you have to select, you have to go to the each and every line and select your town. Okay, your town, how to select from 100 values. Okay, so instead of, that's like waste of time, right? Yeah. So here same like a Google, so automatically it comes. So here if you just say J, see jQuery, everything. Okay, so just select jQuery, it will be added. So this is the beauty of data list, the list of all the data options. Okay, yeah. So now we have done with this, and one small example what I want to show is, see why we are adding this value submit is, so that keep depend on each browser. So let me open this in the same form, let me open in the Chrome. So because value you must have to add every time. Okay, so let me open this in the Chrome, enter. Yeah, I'll just show you the difference. Simple difference is there here. See HTML forms loaded, right? Yeah, here if you just let me do something. If you forget to give this value attribute, so what happens if you just give only submit, input type equal to submit. See here, only for the last value I have given only type equal submit. See for this Chrome, for the Chrome it is submit only, but if you open in the Mozilla Firefox, if you just refresh it, see what is this one, submit query. Even though you have given input type equal to submit, but here based on this browser, this Mozilla Firefox will gives like submit query. Okay, so it's like different, right? So here submit button and here submit query. So if you don't want to get this, and if you want a universal name, so just simply give the value here. So here value submit. So what happens, see here also submit, and this browser also it is submit. Okay, yeah. So instead of submit, you can just add any value, just say send. Okay, send. So what happens, so in the Chrome it is send, and here also it is send. Okay, so whatever the actual value you want to add for the button, so that you can add over here. Okay, yeah. So in this class we have discussed this HTML form elements. Okay, so what are these types of HTML form elements? So in the next video, we are going to discuss the HTML input types. So for the input tag, so what are the various input types are required, and so HTML5 input types and everything. Okay, so after that we'll discuss HTML form input attributes. So what are the different attributes has come, and in the HTML5 version what are the different attributes, and finally we build one online job application form. Okay, so by clubbing all this. So I'm done with this today now. So you can just practice this. So in the next video we are going to discuss this input types. Okay, yeah, thanks for watching.